first thing is, Northern is a very big unit, as you know. It covers almost the whole of the north of England. It's a 9-year franchise, which was let in April 2016. The franchise was drawn up by DFT and Rail North, which is the organisation made up of local transport authorities in Northern England. And it is managed, this is one of the few devolved franchises, which is managed by the Rail North Partnership based in Leeds in the north of England. I think it's also, just to remind members, that when this franchise was originally due to be let, the intention was it would continue on the previous basis, which was subsidy from the government would continue to decline, and that would be done through service reductions and fares increases. It was the involvement of Rail North actually turned that around so that the subsidy reduction of government would be driven not by service reduction but by service growth and revenue growth. So this is now much more a growth agenda and delivering the services across the north of England that so desperately needed. We operate a significant number of services, both commuter services into big and conurbations, interurban services across the north of England, as well as a lot of rural services, particularly in places like 476 stations, so again, a lot of stations ranging from very big stations that you're well aware of in the Liverpool City region through to unstaffed halts in rural areas. And we currently employ, and that number's actually wrong, it's over 5,800 people across the north, so we are also one of the bigger employers in the north of England. And just to give you a little bit of context, that number has grown in the last year, calendar year, by nearly 400 people, so we're a growing business. We employ more people now than we did a year ago. And just for context, last year we had about 26,000 applications for the new jobs that we were advertising. So we are an employer that people want to work for because of the transformation that we're driving, but also because the terms and conditions and the salary offer is quite robust in the transport market. One of the innovations that was brought forward in this franchise was the creation of the regional director roles. So this is such a big franchise, we decided to put in place four regional directors. Sharon is your local regional director looking after parts of Lancashire, Cllr, and the Liverpool City region, amongst others. And that really gives a local feel to it. So I've been sat in this chamber before under the previous franchise, and we've had a stakeholder manager that's come along, listened to all your concerns, written them down, and disappeared back to your for a while, and then come back to us. But now we've got a team that is based over here to understand local issues, to respond to stakeholder needs, to work with community about partnerships and station adoption, which I'm sure we'll want to talk about a bit later. But really understand what you're doing here, making sure that we're playing our role, whatever it is that you, the city region, are doing beyond smart city, independent travel, or whatever, and making sure that what we're delivering is to your satisfaction. So just a quick recap of some of the more exciting things that we've got in the franchise. The intention is that we provide more services, faster journey times, more frequent journeys in the evenings, weekends and Sundays, and trying to catch up a sort of lost generation of rail travel in the north. We've also got significant amounts of money to invest in our stations. We have 476, but we do have a pot of money around £60 million, which is our contribution, which we hope to match fund with local contributions from stakeholders to get more out of our system to improve the station and pop. A key part of the franchise is improving the customer service. So actually when measured on the level of customer satisfaction, both on trains, so the onboard service that people get, but also the service they get through our customer experience centre and our stations, and trying to drive that forward is because we want our customers to be more satisfied. Also, clearly, that drives more fare revenue for us to make the franchise more sustainable. We're also investing significant amounts of money in safety and security. So we know that travelling on our trains is a safe and secure way of travel, but people's perception of travelling on trains sometimes isn't as high as the actual level. So we've invested in 55 travel safety officers who do a great job in complementing our conductors and also our station staff, providing reassurance, providing support for us in difficult situations, late nights, sporting events, etc. And we're also very keen that we work in partnership with our key stakeholders, sort of toe in the water on delivering improved timetables. Although the franchise was let in April 2016, I think the first year or so has been quite one of considerable planning, so you don't suddenly get new trains or refurbished trains just like that. But what we are starting to see now is those big promises around new rolling stock and refurbished trains actually coming to fruition. So we do have a significant number of new trains that are being built by CAF in Spain. I've got a little video just to show you how that's going on. And they will be factory contract tested later this year and entering service later in 2018. We have, I think, slightly more now, but we have 60 or 70 completely refurbished trains. So these are older trains, but they've been through works either in Crewe or Doncaster, using local resource to completely refurbish them, putting in new seats, internal and external refurbishment to make them look as if they're new. And the first ones of those are going through a further process of modernisation this month by having Wi-Fi and further digital capacity put onto those trains so that people can see when the next train stop is and use the Wi-Fi. We also opened